Let us talk about array of structures. So you don't need to be thinking any differently when you're talking about normal array versus an array of structures, because a structure is a user created or a user defined data type. So let us say I want to keep track of some, say, 20 or 30 students' name and marks in a particular subject test I have conducted. Let's say I have conducted a test in maths and I want to keep track of the name of the student as well as the marks he or she got in that particular test. Now, if I use a single structure, I can store the name and mark of just one student. But if I use an array of structures, I can keep track of a number of students. So I have defined max as 50. And here what I have done is I have defined a class of 50. That means if you take a look at this particular type def, I have said student record. It has the name whose maximum characters are 50 as well as the marks of a particular student. Now, since I have used type def struct student rec and then said student, I can define a variable of this particular student record by using this particular student. Alright. So I have said student class of max. That means now class is an array of this type of structure. I'll repeat, class is an array of a structure of name and marks. Since max is 50, so class can store 50 names and 50 marks of respective students. Now I'm using a variable count because although I have a capacity to store 50 names and their marks, I may be interested to read only say 10 students' names and marks. So I'm asking the user how many students you want to store the name and marks. That is going to be stored in count. So count keeps track of that. So the value of I is initially not given anything, but you will know why I is used. So what I am going to do here is, I'll first explain the main, then we'll jump other side. For I is equal to 0, for I less than count, I am reading the data for student 0. Okay, I have a function called as read record. In read record, I am reading the data for student 0 and assigning it to class of 0. Okay, in the 0th structure, the 0th student or the first student data will actually get stored. I will become 1, then again the first student. I becomes 2, the second student, third student, and so on. So this is very similar to a normal array. So just don't get confused. It's an array of structures. Now, in order to print the class list, that means I want to print, suppose I have taken that I want to enter the name and marks of 10 students. So from starting from 0 to the 10th student, I am going to print student 1's name and marks, student 2's name and marks, student 3's name and marks using this particular function print record. Read record is used to read the name and marks of a student in math subject. Print record is used to print the name and marks of the student of that particular class for all the list of students. Now let's take a look at this read record. So in read record, if you see, what I have done is I have said read record of I. That means for the 0th student, I want to read his data. So I say read record integer I. This is a local variable. This particular read record is going to return a structure of this type, of this data type. So the return type is a student. So I have created a new structure. Okay, I have defined a structure variable NS of this type student. I am asking the names and marks of student I plus 1. Since I is 0, it doesn't make sense for me to ask you enter the 0th student name. So I am saying 0th student's name and marks. So using scanf, I am reading that person's name. And just to show you something extra, I have just said address of ns.mark. This bracket is not necessary because this dot has a higher precedence than and, so not a problem. Alright, just trying to show you something. So once I read the marks of this particular first student in this structure ns, I say return ns. Since ns is of this type student, that record will get assigned to class of 0. Okay, so the zeroth student data is read here. Now I becomes 1. When I is 1, again I create one more structure variable of this particular type. Once I create a structure variable of this particular type, now for the second student, I should enter the name and marks. Although I is 1, I am doing I plus 1 so that user understands now it is the second student. So I will read the name and marks of the second student. Once I read the name and marks, I am going to return the name and marks of the second student through this structure NS. So NS data type is student. Student looks something like this. So when I return NS, in the first position, the next student's data gets stored in array of class. Okay. Now, if I have to print record, it is really easy. I am passing class of I. When I pass class of I, the structure member class of 0 is sent to print record. I am sending by value here. So class of I variable is also of the type student. Okay. Item is also of the type student. So student is a structure type of a variable having this particular format. It is a user defined or a user created data type. So now when I say I want to print name, if I say item.name, it will print the person's name. Item.mark, it will print that person's name and that person's mark. So now if you see what I am trying to do here is, in this array of structures at a very high level, I'll run through what we're trying to do. We have created a structure which can hold track of person's name and marks. Using type def, I have created student. That means student follows this particular data type having a name and marks. In order to create an array of structures, I say student class of max is 50. So it is class is now an array of structures. Like you have array of numbers, array of characters. This is an array of structure. Class 0 will have this, class 1 will have this. Now I'm asking how many students you want to enter. Let's say he says 2 students. So for the 0th student, I'm calling this function read record. Read record, I come here, I create a new structure variable of this particular data type. I ask the person to enter the name and marks. The name and marks are entered. Then I return NS. Now the record created is returned by value and assigned to class of I. So in the class of 0th position of the array, the first student's data gets stored. Same way, second, third and so on. Now I come back here. When I'm saying print record, I'm saying give print, or I'm passing the structure 0 because class of I is 0. I'm passing structure 0. When I'm passing structure 0, it is stored in item. It is passed by value. Item.name will give me the name of the person. Item.marks will give me the marks of that particular person.